Look, guys, we're still doing the show. We're just taking it in a new direction, that's all.
Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I am Brianna Claire, and for this video today, I'm going to be doing a Get to Know Me set. I literally filmed this video 7,522 times. Each and every time, like, the video just looks weird. And when I finally had a video that I liked and started editing it, I had a cookie crumb. So hopefully the video today goes well. Number uno, what is your full name? My full name is Brianna Claire Walker. Number two, what is your zodiac sign? I am a Cancer. I was born July 22nd, 1995. I'm 23 years old, and I definitely identify with my zodiac sign. Like, I'm sensitive. I wouldn't say that I'm a crybaby. I'm just emotionally independent. Like, I don't mind expressing when I'm sad or when something hurts my feelings. Like, I let it be known. And I live a lot in the past too. I hold on to past situations, past people, past relationships. So yeah, I'm definitely a Cancer. And when somebody meets me, it's like they can tell I'm a Cancer too. And then I'm also a Gemini moon and a Capricorn rising. And I have a lot of traits in those zodiac signs too. So I identify with those zodiac signs too. Number three, what is something that really annoys you? Okay, something that really annoys me is when I'm woken up out of my sleep. Like, I am the meanest, grouchiest person ever if somebody wakes me up out of my sleep. I just have, like, a straight attitude. I don't want to talk to anybody. I don't want to do anything. I don't want to look at anybody. I don't want anyone to talk to me. Because I value my sleep. I don't want to be interrupted while I'm sleeping. Number four, what is your biggest fear? Okay, so have you ever seen, like, the videos on YouTube or Facebook, where it's like 10 people in this little bathroom in, like, a different country, like Asia or Brazil, and they're trying to get an anaconda up out of the toilet? That is my fear. I promise you. Anytime I go to the bathroom, I always double check to make sure a snake's not waiting for me in the toilet. Like, I just could not imagine, like, I'm going to use the bathroom and a snake just pops up and bites me on my bum hole. Like, no. Like, that is my biggest fear in the whole wide world. And it sounds crazy. It sounds irrational, but it's very rational. Number five, what is my favorite movie? I have a lot of favorite movies, but if I had to pick my number one favorite movie of all time, it would be The Emperor's New Groove. I love that movie so much. It's so funny. I can just rewatch it and rewatch it and rewatch it and never get tired of it. I need you to see. Number six, what is my favorite band? I have a lot of favorite bands. I like Incubus, Nirvana, I like Deftones, I like Gorillaz, I like Little Dragon, I like The Killers, I like Stereophonics, I like Weezer, I like this band called Tennis, I like this band called Peach Pit. I'm probably forgetting something, somebody. Yeah, I'm forgetting a lot of people because I like a lot of bands, so. Okay, number seven. What is a confession of mine? Okay, so a confession of mine that I have in a book, and I saw a picture of a graph right up above his knee. Okay, I really don't know where it started. It really came out of nowhere. One night, I just said to myself, I'm gonna watch some videos about sharks, and that's where my obsession with sharks came from. So I just watched videos about shark attacks, people who've been bitten by sharks, sharks swimming in water, shark movies, shark bites. Yeah, I'm just really interested in sharks for some reason, and I don't know why. And it's weird because who likes sharks? They're this huge creature who can kill you in one bite. It's really odd. Okay, number 8, my favorite food. I would say my favorite food would have to be steak and mashed potatoes. And I know that's two foods, but that combo, oh my God. It's my favorite food ever, steak and mashed potatoes. Yes. Okay, back to the questions. Number 9. Do you want children, and what would you name them? Yes, I do. I definitely want kids in the future. And I would love to have a girl and a boy. Like, if I had a girl and a boy, I would be satisfied. And I would name my daughter Davy. Yes, Davy. That's D-A-V-E-Y, Clover. Davy Clover. And I got that name from when I was a little kid, actually. When I was a kid, I really, 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 really liked watching ending credits because I love learning about, like, the actors and actresses who played characters that I liked. And so one day, I was 9 years old, I was watching Lilo and Stitch. And I saw that the voice actress for Lilo, her name was Davy Chase. So I said to myself, Davy, I really like that name. I had to name my daughter that. So ever since I was 9 years old, I had my daughter's name picked out. And I don't even like any other names for a girl. It has to be Davy. And for my son, I really like the name Tipton Morrison. And I got that name from London Tipton on Sweet Life of Zack and Cody, I think that's her name. Yeah, so Davy and Tipton. That's what I would name my future kids. Number 10, what is my favorite show? I have a lot of favorite shows. I have a lot of favorite everything. But if I had to just name my favorite show that I'm obsessed with now, I would say Aqua Teen Hunger Force. It's so funny. Like, I watched it when I was a kid, but I really didn't understand what was going on. And now that I'm like an adult and I watch it, it just cracks me up. It's so funny. It's hilarious. Okay, number 11. This is a basic question, but it says how tall am I? I'm 5'3". And number 12. What's something that you really love? Something that I really, really love with my whole heart is writing. I love writing so much. I think because, like, I'm a loner and, like, I'm an introvert, when I write, like, it's just very peaceful to me. Like, it just gives me a feeling that someone is listening to me. It's like the paper is just listening to my words. And then I love writing poetry as well. And I've written so many poems for my school newspaper. So something that I'll do is just leave a link down below in the description box of poems that I've written in case anybody wants to check it out. Number 13, what are my turn-ons in a relationship? My turn-ons, I would have to say, a nice haircut, a nice personality, you're goofy, you can dress, what else? Like, you just can make me laugh. Like, I really love guys that can dress and that have style. That's very attractive to me. Like, you could be butt-ass ugly, but if you can dress, you're so fine to me. And that leads to the next question, what are your turn-offs in a relationship? Okay, my turn-offs in a relationship, like, I don't like guys who don't have a sense of humor. I don't like guys who can't take a joke. Like, I know I'm sensitive, but I know how to joke with people. So it can't be two sensitive people in a relationship. It's just not gonna work. Which leads to the next question. What is my current relationship status? So currently I am single. I've been single now for 2.5 months, going on 3. And, you know, we were in a relationship for a year, but it just, you know, just didn't work out. So I'm enjoying being alone though. Like, it's very peaceful, it's relaxing. Like, I just feel like I'm getting to know myself more and what to look for in my next relationship. Number 16, what is my favorite ice cream flavor? My favorite ice cream flavor is chocolate chip cookie dough, but butter crunch is a runner-up. Number 17, what's something weird about you? Well, there's a lot weird about me, so let me think. Okay, something weird about me is I don't like when my food touches. It's so disgusting. I don't like the sight of it. I will literally not eat anything on my plate if my food touches. I won't eat anything. I'll just throw it away. It just disgusts me. Okay. Number 18, what is something that someone may not know about you? Okay, something that people may not know about me is that I'm a serious gamer. I love playing video games. I've been a gamer since I was a little girl. And I literally have like a stack of video games like this tall. I kid you not. I love playing video games. And I haven't been able to play any video games recently because I've just been so swamped with school. I'm a senior, getting ready to graduate from college. So, and you know how it is your senior year. It's like you have work on top of work on top of work. So once I graduate, I definitely will be getting back to playing games. I think this is number 19. What are three of your favorite albums? Okay. Three of my favorite albums. One, definitely, 1999 by Joey Badass. That's my favorite mixtape of all time. I remember when 1999 came out, I was in high school. It's all I played. Like, every song, back to back to back, I never got tired of it. I was obsessed with it. I even still listen to it today. Like, that album really changed my life. Like, it introduced me to Joey Badass and Capital Steve, just all of pro era. And I would say my top two favorite album would have to be Nirvana Unplugged. Every song on the album. Where Did You Sleep Last Night is one of my favorite songs by them. And then I would have to say my third favorite album is Young Thug, Barter 6. And that was actually a Barter 6 song that just went off. And I don't really listen to that much of like the new Thug, just because he's just not the same as he used to be. And I think that that song came out like years ago. Number 20. What type of music do you listen to? I listen to all types of music. Clearly, if you couldn't tell. Like, that's just me. I've always been like that. I don't just listen to R&B and rap. I don't even really listen to a lot of R&B. I mostly listen to rap and alternative. That's really all that I listen to. Number 21. Where do you want to travel? I would love to travel to Japan, but most especially I would love to travel to the Studio Ghibli Museum. Oh my God, that's something I really dream about. Next question. Speaking of anime, what is your favorite anime? Goodness. Okay, if I had to pick my favorite anime of all time, definitely Nana. And that's my favorite manga too. Like, when I tell you that Nana is one of the most realistic animes and manga that I've ever seen, it's so realistic. And it's one of those animes that after I finished watching it, I could not stop thinking about it. Like, it's that good. And unfortunately, like, it's never been completed, the manga or the anime, because the author got sick. And I literally check on the anime and the manga every day. Not every day, but I check on it a lot just to see if it'll ever get updated. Yeah. This is my favorite anime. Definitely. And one question that I saw was, what is your favorite anime soundtrack? My favorite anime soundtrack, I would say, would have to be Samurai Champloo. Because Samurai Champloo introduced me to Nujabes. So definitely, yeah. Definitely Samurai Champloo. So I think that's it for all the questions. I really hope everybody got to just learn a little bit about me. And I hope it's not too awkward. I hope I didn't annoy you if I said like a lot. So yeah, make sure to like, please subscribe, please comment. And I hope to see you back in my next video. It's all of you.
And the world don't respect you, and the culture don't accept you, but you think it's all love. And the girls gon' neglect you once your parody is done. Reputation can't protect you if you never had one. Jealousy,
conflict,
emotional,
conflict,
self-pity,
conflict,
under oath,
conflict.
The loudest one in the room, nigga, that's a complex. Let me put it back in proper context.
You ain't gotta lie to kick it, my nigga. You ain't gotta lie, you ain't gotta lie. You ain't gotta lie to kick it, my nigga.